Hi, everyone. Welcome to the Studio Classroom Coffee Corner. We're so glad that you're joining us today. We want to continue our look at the best winter adventures in the world. These are Studio Classroom's top five. I think you'll enjoy this. Stay with us.
Yeah, stay with us as we go to Japan and we learn about a snow festival they have in Sapporo.
Wait, I always thought Japan was a warm place. You know, Okinawa, down in the southern part of Japan? It's practically tropical, isn't it?
Well, not exactly tropical, but it does get warm. But northern Japan gets quite cold, especially in the wintertime.
And not only does it get cold, but they get a lot of snow.
That's right. In fact, the Winter Olympics were held there in 1972, so they get a lot of snow.
All right. And in today's lesson, we'll find out what they do with all that snow up in Sapporo.
That's right. And we do want to take a look at this, but before we do, we want to review quickly. We went to, let's see, the Gulf of St. Lawrence last time, right?
Yeah, to the Magdalen Islands in Canada. We got a crash course in ice safety so we could take a look at those harp seals.
That's right. Those cute harp seals in their cute little pups that are snow white out on those ice fields.
That's right. So that was the first one that we showed you. We're going on to number two right now. Not necessarily in this order, I guess. We're not rating them necessarily as the top one and top two, but these are five that Studio Classroom thinks are great. So let's go now to Sapporo, Japan.
Snow Festival in Sapporo, Japan. Imagine seeing the Great Wall of China made of snow in Japan. In mid-February each year, Sapporo hosts the world's best-known ice sculpture competition. Experts carve more than 300 sculptures. Some are several stories tall. Castles, dinosaurs, and cartoon characters transform the streets of Sapporo and fill the city's Odori Park. Recent festival goers have also admired the Statue of Liberty and other world-famous statues and buildings. At night, music and colored lighting turn the town into an icy dream world. The festival attracts more than 2 million visitors every year.
Well, I think we have all heard about this event that takes place every year in Sapporo, Japan. There's a festival there, and it's pretty impressive.
Now, a festival is just a series of special events, sometimes things like performances. Also, you can have music concerts or something that takes place over a number of days. Mm-hmm. And so this isn't something that just is a one-day event. You can go and enjoy several days in Sapporo.
Right, and usually you celebrate something in a festival. And I think here they're celebrating the winter and they're celebrating the snow that is there during this time of year.
You might as well, because what else can you do, right?
Right.
There's so much snow. Well, it says, imagine seeing the Great Wall of China made of snow.
In Japan.
Right. I think the Great Wall is in mainland China, right?
That's right.
You would think that it would be there. That's where most people would go to see it. But at this particular time, in mid-February, if you want to go to Japan, I guess you can get a little bit of China and Japan at the same time.
Mm-hmm. That's right. So imagine seeing this, the Great Wall of China in Japan, but this wall is made of snow.
That's right. And we go on to find out about this. It says in mid-February each year, Sapporo hosts the world's best-known ice sculpture competition. So there is a competition going on. People are competing to see who can actually sculpt the most beautiful or most impressive sculpture. Now, what I read is that actually these experts are people who come from all over the world, and they want to compete because they want to be the best.
And it's what a great place to go. You can see all the best people who make these sculptures in one place during the same time of the year. Now, we've used the word sculpture. We've used the word sculpt. You might be wondering, what is this word, or what does it mean?
Okay, and the word sculpture is actually a piece of art that is made from wood or clay or stone or
like here, it's made of ice.
Mm-hmm.
And they sculpt it. They often cut it with using different types of tools so they can get the form that they want.
Another helpful word in understanding what sculpting is about is in that next sentence. Mm-hmm. It says, experts carve more than 300 sculptures. And part of sculpting is carving, which means you just make an object into a shape by cutting off pieces of the material that it's made of.
Now, I think most of us, we could go out there and we could have a block of ice and we could start cutting and do a great work, right? But in the end, no one would recognize what it is. But these sculptors, they have quite a gift, quite a talent, and in the end, what they produce is quite impressive.
Right. And I don't think these things are just out of one little block of ice, because in the next sentence it says that some of these sculptures are several stories tall. Now, a story is a way that we measure a building, how high it is, maybe 5 stories or 7 stories. But some of these sculptures are several stories tall.
That's amazing.
It is amazing, and 300 of these sculptures. Not all of them are that tall, but what's amazing to me is this started in around 1950, and at that time there were only six sculptures, and about 5,000 visitors came. Today, there are over 300 sculptures, and they're several stories high, and at the very end of the article, we see more than 2 million visitors, right?
Amazing.
Absolutely incredible. And they come to see all the fun sculptures. It's not just that they're going to see people or buildings made out of ice, but they'll see castles, they'll see dinosaurs, they're going to see their favorite cartoon characters, and they're all over the streets in Sapporo.
That's right. It actually uses this word. They transform the streets of Sapporo. They change the look totally. So if you go there in mid-February, it's going to look much different than if you go maybe in the middle of the summer.
This covers 11 city blocks. And that's a large area when you think about it, 11 city blocks. Because a block by itself is quite a large area when you're thinking about sculptures like this.
So it covers all those blocks, and inside of those blocks that it covers is this Odori Park. And these sculptures actually fill the park. So they will be found everywhere inside the park.
Okay, well, another statue that has been seen recently is one that most Americans know very well, the Statue of Liberty, but made of ice.
That's right, and other famous statues and buildings that people would recognize, right, from around the world. But, right, they admire them. They're festival goers. Now, could we use that, like, movie goers? Could you say that?
Sure, people that go to movies, we call movie goers. People that go and attend these festivals, we call them festival goers.
You could also say a concert goer, if somebody maybe went to a concert to listen to music.
Well, I guess this is most impressive at night, because when they put the lights on these beautiful ice sculptures, it just does something magical.
Yeah.
Right?
This would be probably some of the most exciting time for me, the most beautiful time to see these ice sculptures.
And not only the colored lights that would reflect off the ice, but also there's music playing, which must make it even more wonderful and kind of come to life.
The article says it makes it into an icy dream world, which would make me want to go. And as you mentioned earlier, Vicki, I'm not the only one that would want to go.
No, not at all. The festival attracts, it says, more than 2 million visitors every year. So that's a lot of people, but it's only for a short time, several days, that you can enjoy this.
That's right.
So, which would you choose, this one or
I still
Saint
want to
Lawrence?
See the seals.
Oh, the seals.
They're so cute.
Maybe we'll have to do both of them.
Yeah, well, we still have more to look at, so don't make your choice yet, okay? We'll take a short break, and in a moment, we'll come back and take a look at another.